and welcome everyone to this video on debugging ABAP programs by ZaranTech. But before we begin, make sure to subscribe to our ZaranTech YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to never miss any update from us.
So, hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss the basic debugging techniques in ABAP. So, what is debugging? So, debugging is a technique by which we can find any error and we can correct the error and detect the error. And we always prefer desktop 3 as it provides more space to see the data more clearly. Now see how we can put a debugger. Suppose this is my program, which I have written from VBAK table and VBAP table. And I have written this program to display the ALV using reuse ALV grid display. Now see, simply activate the program. Activate the program and go to startup selection event and put a debugger. How will put the debugger? Activate the program, select the line and click on this particular button to put a debugger. Either you can put a debugger by clicking on this particular red icon, or you can select the line and click on the left portion. The debugger will be or put automatically on that particular line. Simply put the breakpoint on the executable statement, any executable statement I just put here on the select query, and click on execute button and it will automatically stop at that particular point. So simply click on this particular execute button. Now give input and click on execute button. Simply see our debugger has been stopped and it stopped at that particular line where I put the breakpoint here. Now, just go to desktop 3 and we can see the desktop 3 provides us more space where we can see all the data clearly. If you will use the standard screen, you will get less space here. So it is always more preferable to use the desktop 3. Now, we have the various button which we use for basic debugging techniques. I am going to explain one by one. So we have execution keys in debugging. The first one is F5 button. Simply put F5 from your keyboard, or you can click on this particular icon. F5 is used for step-by-step execution. Execute the program. It executes the program one line at a time, allowing you to step through each line of code, indicating stepping into function calls for detailed inspection. Then we have a F6 button. And what this particular F6 button does, it also executes the line by line execution. It is similar to F5, but it skips over function calls. That is, if there will be any function call, it will skips over the function call, executing only the current line of code and moving to the next line. That is, it will directly execute your function call and it will move towards the next line. So you can simply put F6 on your keyboard, or you can click on this particular button. Then we have F7 button. F7 returns. It is used for return. It steps out of the current function, allowing you to quickly return to the calling function's context. Then we have F8. F8 is used for continuous execution or exit. It resumes continuous execution of the program until the next breakpoint is encountered or until the program completes. Can also be used to exit debugging mode. That is, if I will put F8 button, this is my F8 button and this is my F7. Either put F7 or F8 from keyboard, or you can click on this particular icon. You can see continue for F8, return for F7. Now just double click on any variable. You can see it will automatically appear on the right side. And currently, I can see there is no data. Now, I will press F5 for line iteration. And see, we are getting 10 record. Just double click on the variable. And it will appear in more detail. And we can see all the data that are present here. Now, we also have some system variables in debugging mode, which we can use. They are sizeFRC and siteTabX. These are system variables that are by default present in the debugging mode. Let me show to you. See, they are by default present here. You can also write it here. and see its value. Just put it size sub RC and press enter. See, its value is 0. You can also click on here to write its value. Then we have site tabix and press enter. See, automatically, we can see automatically its value is present here. Then we have also a static and dynamic program breakpoint in debugging. So this is how we can use debugging for our program, and we can check any error. Simply see, press F8 and TLV will be displayed. My program will be executed completely here and my ALB got displayed here. So in simple way, debugging is a technique by which we can find the error, correct the error, and detect the error. It is always more preferable to use Desktop 3 as it provides more space to see the data more clearly, and breakpoint can be only given to any executable statement. And what is an executable statement? So any statement that performs some execution is termed as executable statement. The program must be in active state to put a breakpoint on it. So this is all about my basic debugging techniques. So thank you very much.